Most of you are probably still working with the IFC2X3 and eventually giving IFC4 a try from time to time, but there are more and more discussions about IFC4.3, and today I want to highlight the differences and also explain the big advantages of IFC4.3, especially for the infrastructure. As you already know, IFC is based on classes, which define the functions, the properties, and the dependencies of objects. The hierarchy of the classes is quite a complex topic, so I'll explain it in a very simplified way. In IFC2X3 and also still in IFC4, we basically had one main class for the visible geometrical objects, and this was IFC Building, which again contains classes to describe the building elements like walls, doors, and so on. And also a more generic class for everything else, the famous IFC Building Element Proxy. This makes it clear that IFC was initially developed for the buildings. However, there are no buildings without the infrastructure, so we need to find ways to export the infrastructure, like roads and bridges as well. As you can imagine, in IFC2X3, we had to assign these to the IFC Building Element Proxy, which is not so great. Simply because it's actually a container full of stuff that doesn't belong anywhere else and also doesn't provide much intelligence when it comes to dependencies, the properties, and so on. This is why IFC4.3 is such a big game changer. For the first time, we now have next to the IFC building also the dedicated classes for the infrastructure, like IFC bridge, rail, and so on. IFC4.3 is actually still being developed and it's not an official ISO standard yet. And you can check the progress on the Building Smart website at any time. And as you can see here, the Building Smart is already working on the IFC4.4, and also for IFC4.3, we still don't have the dedicated model view definitions for infrastructure, which is another important point I would like to discuss with you. All previously developed MVDs are based on the buildings or the vertical structure, where basically every element has its X, Y, Z coordinates in space. Now, the infrastructure or the horizontal structures are constructed in a different way. They have an alignment, which is basically a virtual spatial curve that represents the middle of the street, a railway, a bridge, and so on, and all the elements like rails, light poles, walkways, and so on are referenced in relation to this alignment. This leads to not only more accurate models, but also requires less data to describe a horizontal structure. This is why IFC alignment was first introduced in IFC4.1 and has been further developed since. Now that we know what IFC4.3 is about, let's have a look at how we can export it from Civil 3D. For this, you will need the latest version of Civil 3D 2022 or newer, and the IFC 4.3 extension, which you can find in the Autodesk account along with all the other updates, or also, of course, in the Autodesk desktop app. Once installed, you'll have access to a range of commands from the command line, starting with IFC Infra. If you don't see these commands, then it means you haven't installed the plugin yet. Notice that one of these commands is IFC Infra Help, which will lead you to the official help sections, which explains the most important aspects of all the available commands. Anyway, we will now have a closer look at each of these commands together. The first and the most important one is the IFC Infra Export. This will export the whole model with the default settings, which we will do for the first test. Notice that you will get notifications if you have missing references or unsupported items, like in my case. It's also important to keep in mind what actually the IFC 4.3 Civil 3D export supports at the moment. These are cocoa points, feature lines, tin and tin volume surfaces, corridors, bridges, sites, pressure and gravity pipe networks, as well as the AutoCAD elements like 3D polylines, solids and blocks. Once exported, it is important to review the file in a viewer which fully supports IFC 4.3. At the moment, I recommend you to use the OpenIFC Viewer by ODA, which I am also using here. As you can see here, the elements were automatically exported, to their dedicated IFC classes and have all the properties which were defined in civil and also standard IFCP sets defined in the schema for this class. Just as a comparison, here you can see how the structure looks like in the old IFC 2.3. We have a ton of IFC building element proxies and you can only differentiate them based on their name, and they also don't have any specific P sets. I think this shows very clearly that IFC 4.3 is definitely the way for infrastructure. Now let's have a look which other options and settings we can select in Civil 3D. The main configuration file can be generated using the command IFC infra save config, and this will generate a JSON file. By default, this file will be saved in the same folder where your DWG is stored. The file is actually quite easy to understand, but you can also have a look at the help we mentioned before, where the basic concept is also briefly explained. In general, what you can do here is change, for example, the IFC version the plugin is using. The default one is IFC 4.3, but you could also, for example, use a specific release candidate or the draft of the 4.4 schema. If you are thinking now, what is she talking about? Just leave the setting the way it is. In this file, you can also add some more general information related to the project, like the author or the facility information, for example. I'll just add a couple of examples to try this out. When exported again, you should see these properties on the top level containers. The second configuration file you can use to tweak your export is the mapping configuration, meaning we are now moving one level down from the top containers to the actual elements. The command IFC infra save mapping config will again generate a JSON file, which you can easily edit in order to exclude specific categories or change the mapping between civil objects and the IFC classes. Again, this is something you should only do if requested or if it's needed. The standard settings are actually recommended and cover the typical use cases. Last but not least, there is a third configuration file, which is generated using the command IFC infra save property template, which will actually generate two files, a JSON file and a CSV file. Having a look at the help documentation, you can again review how to use these files in detail. So basically, if you have no mapping, all the properties from Civil 3D will be exported, and the files we're just generating are actually just listing all of the property sets and the properties you currently have in the model. You can now review the files and exclude specific property sets, add a description, change their names, and so on. In the CSV file, you even have all the properties listed and can also edit or exclude them. Now, last but not least, there is one export setting, which is, from my point of view, the most important one, and that one is the set project base point. You see, in architecture, we are working with local base points and only reference the GIS coordinates to know where the building is in the world, while the infrastructure projects are carried out using the GIS coordinates in the first line. And this is causing all of the issues we have in the coordination using shared coordinates. If you are a Revit user, you know what I mean. Now, IFC 4.3 can transmit the local base point, but also the GIS coordinates in the background. And you can define the local base point in Civil 3D using the command IFC infra set project base point. This will allow you to select a 3D point in the model, and you will also see where the new project base point is placed. Last thing I would do before exporting is double checking if I really need everything in my IFC file. For example, I could only select the actual structure in this case and then use the command IFC infra export selected to export only this portion of the model. This time I load this model in the Autodesk Docs viewer, as we of course also support viewing IFC 4.3 files here. And as you can see here, I have a similar view to what we saw before in the Open IFC viewer, and only the portion of the model I had selected is exported now. I can of course also browse the file structure and review the property sets. That's it for today. If you would like to have a next video to see what we can do now with this file we just exported in Revit, then please leave a comment. See you in the next video.